What's up, YouTube? The German here again, and welcome to back to the Arsenal save. And first of all, I'm sorry I have been away for a few days. I have slightly ill, and also we have things going on at the home, so that's why there haven't been any Arsenal video in a couple of days. But today there will be a big video. Today we have a game against Manchester City. But before that, we have games in recap, and also transfers has happened since the last time we saw each other. In outs, there are a lot of loanees. Ajer, De Wilhelna, Amari, Nuri, Marimon, Fischer, Sturges, Sharpers, Penacor, and those guys have gone out of a loan, and I did sold Kieran Gibbs to Torino, 15.25 million. Not that much money that I would have like to have on him, but he was third choice left back, so I let him go. I also sold Alex Iwobi. He looks really good winger, but we have Alexis Sanchez, and we have players like Bale, Caleri, and Walcott, so we really don't need Iwobi. And Aston Villa were paying 5 million for him, so I let him go. Then there was one big sell at the end of the transfer window. I did sold Aaron Ramsey to Paris Saint-Germain for 80 million. That's all 80 million in the same time, so there is no installments on that transfer. Quite happy for that, because we have a lot of talented young guys in the midfield, so I was thinking that Aaron was one of the better players in our midfield, but I would like to give those young guys like Bazur and Balic to time to play in the big game, so I decided to let Aaron go. 80 million is a good price for him. He's 26 years old, and he had those injury problems all along, so that's why I let him go. And I also bought one guy, James Sturges from Ajax Auxerre, 15 million. This guy looks really, really good. He's only 1.5 star right midfielder at the moment, but his potential is at 3.5, maybe 4.5 stars. So, and for 21 years old, his attributes are really good at the moment also. So really looking forward to him in the next couple of seasons. He is current at our affiliate club FC Lorient for loan for this season. And then the games. Last time was that Community Shield, 1-1 and lost by penalties. After that, we did play one friendly. It was John Terry's testimonial game, I think it was. I don't know why it won't say it here. I think it was that, and yeah, it was 2-2. Nothing special there. After that, we start our Premier League campaign with two good games. 2-0 against Watford. Paco Alcacer, Jonathan Caleri gave us the goals. At the late stage of the game, Matheus Pereira did injured in this game, and he's out 2 months, I think. Nothing special on stats, really even game, a lot of playing in the midfield, and yeah, luckily we did get two goals and managed to win the game. Then there was home game against Crystal Palace, and this game we were really dominant. If we look at the stats, 24 shots, 11 on target, and they got only 6 shots, 2 on target. We got nearly 60% of possession, so really, really good game. And 3 goals, Paco Alcacer and Jonathan Caleri also, yet again, both our strikers score, and Mesut Özil starts his season really good, scoring a goal for this also. And Alexis Sanchez got 2 assists also, so really, really good game. And we did rotate our former players a lot. Borja Zan Emeterio got his game, Christian Bielik is there, Balic and Tielemans also, so a lot of young guys in the field. After that we got a little slip, 1-1 against QPR away, Paco Alcacer scoring it again, giving us the lead, but Charlie Austin equalized the game in 52nd minute. If we look at the stats, they were really, really even, I think. We got slightly more shots and slightly more shots on target, but still it was really even game. After that, we did manage to come back yet another good game in home. 2-0 win against Leicester. Alexis Sanchez, his first of the year, and Mesut Özil's second of the year, gave us the 2-0 win. And yet again, if we look at the stats, we were really dominant. 18 shots, 11 on target. They got 9 shots, none of them on target. So our defense was really good on this game. Then it was probably the best game in this period of time. 4-2 win against Liverpool, who's really good side. Alexis Sanchez got praise. Francis Coquelin's first in the year, and Jonathan Caleri scored his third, I think it is third goal of the year. Mario Balotelli got praise from them, and he was actually only guy who stand out for the team Liverpool in this game. In stats wise, the game was pretty even. 19 shots, 11 on target. They got 13 and 8, 55 and 45% those possessions. So really even game, and we managed to score 2 goals more than our opposition, and managed to grab a good win. And the last game was our start of the Champions League campaign. 1-1 draw against Monaco away. I think it was really good game for us, really even with the stats. 18 and 6 and 12 and 3 for those shots, and yeah, we were slightly on that possession, but still 1-1. Mesut Özil gave us the lead. Actually, Ivan Cavalera gave them the lead, and Mesut Özil equalized the game just before halftime. And if we look at our Champions League group, we have Schalke, Monaco, and Panathinaikos is in our group. So tight group, I think. Schalke will be a big test. And Monaco, of course, is a quality team, but I think Panathinaikos is that one team that everybody's gonna beat in the group. But today we have a game against Manchester City, so let's go to the game. So here is our lineup: Rulli in goal, Parra, Jimenez, Koscielny, Bellerin in our defensive line, Tielemans and Coquelin in midfield, Gareth Bale on left, Mesut Özil in the advanced playmaker role, Jonathan Caleri, of course, in the right-hand side, and Paco Alcácer in our striker position. And in the bench, we have Jason Murillo, Richard Lipazur, Sven Bender, Erik Sviatchenko, Peter Cech, Borja Sanemeterio, and Alexis Sanchez. The reason I drop Sanchez is because his condition is only 89%, and of course match sharpness is 99, but I would like to have Gareth Bale in this game in field, because I think he's gonna be really good on against those big teams. And let's go to the game. Let's look. Man City are of course favorite because it's their home game. They got Joe Hart in goal, Rodriguez, Otamendi, Kompany, Zabaleta, Casemiro, Touré, Felipe Anderson, Adam Lallana, Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain, and Sergio Aguero in striker position. In bench, Hauga, Wambiga, Vidal, Paka, Wolbeck, Kolarov, and Fernandinho. So really, really big names, and there are a couple of guys who have played for us: Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain and Danny Welbeck, of course. Hopefully really good result for this game. Let's say things and stuff for the players, and let's put replays on call action, and let's start the game. We are the red dots, of course, and they are the light blue, and we start the game. Bellerin, the first chance was there, and we have a throw in. Bellerin got the ball. Özil, ball in the box. Parra is there in the back line there, and wow. 4 minutes gone, and Parra gave us the lead 1-0. What a shot that was. Let's look it on 3D. I was thinking that he's gonna cross the ball in the back post. Here Özil finds Parra nicely. He takes two step, and hit it the left-footed shot in the back of the net, and Joe Hart was powerless there. Nice goal, 1-0 to us, and oh my, will it be instant equalizer because the highlight started in the middle of the pitch. Now Anderson got the shot, but it gone over, and thank God it wasn't the equalizer in immediately. And Oxlade-Chamberlain got injured. That is good. Alex Vidal came for the pitch, and it seems that City's conditions are quite low in few players. That is something we should focus on. Hard tackle those players who had low conditions. So we have free kick. Özil, Anderson got the ball. That is annoying that the player who gave the free kick won't go to the ball for those situations and don't let them score. They have four players in the box. Vidal, and it's back of the net. 1-1. Alex Vidal's first goal of the year, and I'm slightly annoyed about that defending error there. If you look, all of our players are in the middle, and no one's marking those players. And yeah, 1-1. 40 minutes gone, and they have a goal kick. Company Otamendi now finds Anderson again. Casemiro closed them down. Aguero got a knock also. Anderson in the box finds Aguero, who shots, and that sounds like a fluke goal to me. It was so far out. I don't understand how. Let's look at Philip Anderson got the ball. Two players were harassing him, and that was a quality shot. There was, I think, there. Yeah. Hopefully we can come back to the game. Koscielny, Jimenez. Can we create an instant reply? Bailey's through. Can he go for the goal? He did into the post. Hart made the save, and we win a corner. Özil, ball in the box. Caleri, Touré tackles, and Bellerin came for tackle him, and the highlight was there. They have a throw in. Rodriguez, Anderson again. Back to Rodriguez, now close him down. Bellerin tackles, good tackle for Bellerin. Now can we go forward and attack? Tielemans finds Özil. Now the Mendy game and tackle for him. And Aguero is through there, but Pará makes a nice interception. Poor passing, Bellerin, Tielemans, straight to Casemiro, and they have a chance, Aguero, and it's gonna be a goal, 3-1. Poor defending, poor passing. I have to say aggressive, demand more, because those passes are, if we look here, well, it's gone for behind the other. Good pass, and in those situations, Sergio Aguero is so talented, good striker, so not gonna do anything. Joe Hart finds Otamendi, Touré. Now Manchester City have taken control of the game. We have possession, but they have the chances. Yet again they are coming, and Lallana, and almost 4-1 in the first half. Not happy at all. In 10 minutes they have created 3 goals. Let's say aggressive, I want to see something else. And let's go to the opposition instructions. Let Hart tackle. Closing down, Hart tackle Aguero. Hopefully he's gonna take them. They have to take him off. Let's go to the summary. Anderson got 4 key passes. Rodriguez got 57% of cross completion radio. So those guys we need to close down. Rodriguez close down and hard tackle and put it on weaker foot. Hard tackle, no. And Anderson also closing down. Hard tackle and weaker foot. Hopefully let's close down Vidal also for the second half. And can we make a substitution? I don't. There is not that many guys that we really could bring on that who's gonna make any difference. Let's go attack. I'm not gonna bring Sanchez yet to the field. Let's start the second half with these guys. Hopefully we could come back. It's a hard task, but. Good tackle for Jimenez. Now, can we create a goal in the first minutes here? No. Company for Firkic, Zapaleta, Fans Casemiro, Aguero is already there. Anderson now close him down, tackle Aguero. Tackle him. Why they don't tackle him? and he almost made it for one. They really should tackle him. Koscielny, Jimenez clears the ball, Zabaleta back to Rodriguez, and the highlight is on over. Now it's our highlight, Özil, Coquelin, Tielemans, Franz Bale. Can Bale score? No. Caleri in the back post, headed, and it's 3-2. Jonathan Caleri's fourth of the year gave us the hope to come back for this game. And Bale take good out for the pass, and I think it was slightly on Joe Hart for that. He should have saved it, but he didn't. And 60 minutes gone. I want to do one change. Let's bring Bale for the striker. Let's bring Alexis Sanchez for that Rondaiter role in the left-hand side, and hope that makes some difference. They have a free kick. Rodriguez. Aguero clears it back to Rodriguez. Now tackle him and take the ball. Good. Now Özil finds Caleri. There is free space. Sanchez is through. Can he find Pellerin? Oh, Pellerin, you got the chance. Oh, man. Where was Bale, our striker? Our right back was the highest man on the pitch. The last minute of extra time is on the cards. Lallana. And the game is over. Manchester City 3, Arsenal 2. I'm not really happy. I'm not happy with the result here, because if we look at the stats, they are pretty even. And those three goals in 10 minutes, there was the black 10 minutes in our end. And yeah, of course, Aguero is a world-class striker, but yet again, those were the defending errors of our team, and that drops us in the fourth spot of the table. Yet again, we are only 1 point behind those other top three teams, so that is the good stuff. And let's look then next time when we gonna be here. Let's go all the way to the Chelsea game. Let's recap a lot of games. Next time, it's gonna be Chelsea in the Bridge away game. So, and thumbs up if you like the video, and subscribe if you are new. That way you will always know when the new videos is out there. And once again, I'm apologizing that there haven't been a video for day or two, but I have been sick, and hopefully you guys understand it. And yeah, thank you for watching. I'm the chairman, and we'll see you next time.